Hello my dear learners, in this video I am going to discuss about how to test your research questions, what are the steps and how we are going to proceed from collecting data to finalize our results. Usually in our research process, in this video tutorial that I am sharing at the moment, this is the last video of that series. Then we will move on to the inferential statistics like regression and logistic regression and all that. However, today's topic is about the research questions and how we can proceed to test the research questions. So start with the idea of how we can formulate the research questions. Usually in our normal research in social science or any science project, what we do that we first formulate the research questions. I mean, we set the research questions and then we move to the hypothesis and then we move to data collection, right? But the problem is, if you collect your if you set your research question and then according to the research questions you formulate the hypothesis and then you go for the data collections, what will happen, my dear learners? At the halfway through, once you see that the data you have collected is not supporting your research questions nor the hypothesis, then it is very difficult for you to come back again and set a new research questions. Okay, that is the idea. Okay, so what is the smartest way to do the research question setting? Let's assume that you have something in your mind and you want to do research on this field. For example, in this case I would like to discuss a topic. Let's say you're talking about the rural tourism. Okay, rural tourism, and what is the impact of rural tourism in rural employment generation and income generation, right? That is the domain that we're talking about. So once you have this domain, then first you select some variables. Okay, I mean, you can go for either selecting your dependent variable and then select some independent variables, and then you look at the dependent and independent variables and see that what are the data that is required for your objective of the research. Okay, and then you do a pilot project. Let's say you collect a few data set. For instance, if you are looking for 300 samples, okay, you go for 30 samples of your domain related to the variable that you have selected, dependent and independent variable, and then you decide whether you will fulfill your objective in this domain by looking at the data that you have collected or observing the data. If the data allows you to set the research question that you wanted to set at the first place, of course you can go for it and set that research question. However, if your data set is not allowing you to set the research question that is in your mind at the first place, then you should not go for that particular research questions. Rather, you change your mind and then set a new research questions which is and which will support your data as well as your domain objective. So basically, instead of randomly select your research question at the beginning and then select the hypothesis and then go for data collection, my opinion is that starting, you should think about the domain first where you would like to work, and then select some variables at the very beginning, and then you collect few data on depending on those variables, maybe a few data based on your pilot data sample survey, and then observing that data or visualizing that data or the relationship of the data between the dependent and independent variables, you can decide whether the research question that you have in your mind you can go for it or not. So that is the smart way to start your research questions testing. Now once you set the research questions, how can you proceed to test the research question? So that we will discuss in the next slide. Now my dear learners, the roadmap one. What is the roadmap one of testing your research question? So far we have discovered in this video tutorial series that we will summarize to see how we can test our research question. In order to do that, our main target is to find a genuine effect in your population. So you know that our target is to collect the sample, right? And the sample collection is to find out whether there is an effect in your population. If there is no effect, then there is no point of doing any research. So you need to understand whether this is a significant work that you can do. Otherwise, you do not have to pursue for that particular work or research. And how can we do that? First, we collect the sample. As I said, you need to collect the sample. First, you select the domain of your research, then select some variables, and then you can collect some sample. Okay, that is the main process of doing the research at a very initial stage. Then use the model to predict your sample to see whether there is a population, whether there is an effect in your population. So the next step is to select a model for prediction. And then use the model to calculate your test statistics. And you know, in my previous videos, I have discussed about when to select the model, what are the test statistics, and what is test statistics and all that. I would strongly recommend you to please go and see my other videos of this video tutorial series of Discovering Statistics with Dr. Munshi Nasir. Now, my dear learners, if that model that you have select for your prediction can explain a lot of variation in the sample. As you know that the main purpose of the model is to effect versus your error, right? I mean the size and error, right? Effect and error. What are the effect in your model and what is the error that you will incur when you pursue for any model and for your any test. So mainly your test statistics will tell you whether you have more error than effect or you have more effect than error. And if you have more effect in your sample, that it means that you should genuinely pursue for this research. So by looking at this TF or chi-square, any test that is suitable for your work, and we have discussed when to use T statistics and when to use F and normal distribution. We have discussed those things in my earlier series of video of this playlist. Please have a look and you can come back and see what I am talking about. Now, for those who haven't seen it, the test statistics is that if you are looking for fewer sample size, let's say 30, less than 30 sample, then it is better to use T statistics for your prediction or test statistics as a test statistics. So if this value of T statistics, I mean the P value of test statistics, is less than 0.05, then you infer that effect you are looking for in the sample is genuinely exist in the population. So it is better to pursue that research. However, if it is more than 5%, then the effect is too small to be detected. So usually when the hypothesis we set, we start with the null hypothesis that there is no effect, and the alternative hypothesis is there is effect. So if the null hypothesis, I mean when you test with the t-test for example, and the p-value comes less than 5%, so you understand that there is a genuine effect in the population, so you reject your null hypothesis and you accept your alternative hypothesis. Okay, now we have reached our final roadmap strategy. Now, rather than going for test statistics and significance test by using t, chi-square and f-test, we can easily do the simple work like Pearson correlation test. And this is, in my opinion, is a very good way to look at the effect, because in Pearson correlation it has a 0 to 1, I mean the range of this value is 0 to 1, and then we can see from here like -1, 0, and 1, and this is the range. And in this case we can see that 0 means there is no effect in the sample for the population that we are looking for, and 1 means perfect effect. So instead of going for significance, you can always go for the Pearson correlation test. And as you know, in my previous videos I have discussed that, and in this video as well I have discussed that instead of going for research question setting and then hypothesis test and then go for test statistics, it is always good way to see is once you select your domain of your research, then you should go for collecting some data depending on the variable like dependent and independent variable. And by looking at the independent and dependent variable, you can obviously go and test the Pearson correlation, whether there is a relationship between dependent and independent variable. And by looking at the relationship, you can always go for a visualization technique like scatter plot diagram. And after that, you can choose your perfect research question for your research. In the previous videos, I have discussed all those things. Please have a look of this playlist. And in the next video, I'm going to discuss about how we can pursue in more advanced level of model, and how we can pursue in the more advanced level of testing for our research questions. And gradually in this playlist and also in this platform, my YouTube channel, I'm going to discuss about research paper writing and how you can quickly publish in a Scopus journal. And also in several videos, I will discuss about qualitative research. One of my viewer also requested me to create a video based on the NVivo software used for qualitative research, and which I will do in the next video as well. So please be with me. If you like that, it is it creating value to your career, my channel and my effort, then of course please subscribe and be with me, and share if you like with your friends to get more knowledge, and give me some more good suggestions to create more videos and useful things for you. Thank you so much for today, and we will see you in the next tutorial. Bye bye.